10 seconds to go. 5 seconds. 5 seconds. Reserve time.
I speak for the trees.
Dire's pick. Ten seconds to go. 5 seconds. Reserve time.
Sand King.
Radiant's pick.
Ember Spirit.
Radiant's ban. Dire's ban. Ten seconds to go. Okay.
Got all the overlays sorted out, but I forgot to unmute my microphone. But whatever. Here we are. Welcome very much to the Joint Dota League Asia Division 1 Tiebreakers. This is a best of one between Execration and First Departure. Yeah, and the winner of this match will go to the Division 1 and 2 playoffs. No, the loser of this match will go to the Division 1 and 2 playoffs. The winner will stay in Division 1 for next season. So, still everything to play for in this when it comes to that. And it's a best of one, as I mentioned. So, go big or go home. My name is dragondrop. Welcome to the broadcast. And I don't usually cast Asian Dota, but this time around, no one else was available. And I thought to myself, hey, why the hell not? Because I'm craving for Dota, and I hope you feel the same. So yeah, First Departure,
Dire's pick.
Shadow of the former selves I've been told, since four of their players moved to Scythe, just with Lobby
looks like we lost
really
one.
Remaining in chains, being a pop star in the Asian scene, and Execration, considered a tier 2 team, but very talented, so not too sure who I'll give the advantage here, because as I mentioned, I don't know too much about these teams, but I've been told that Execration should have this in the back, but we'll see about that. Yeah, we're looking at the draft, Lycanthrope and Ember Spirit already picked up. Those are two heroes that don't go both through the banning stage. At least in Western Dota, because Lycanthrope is really strong in terms of pushing once it gets only a few core items up. Especially with the Necrobook. I mean, you can just send his minions and they do so much DPS. The Wolves and the Necrobook creeps alone. Simply because the Necro units also benefit from his Feral Impulse passive, which just gives him extra attack speed and damage. Ember Spirit is a hero that can create Reserve enough space time. Early on in the game for the Lycanthrope to find his farm. Simply because he does a lot of early game damage. We'll see if they want to combine that up with something like a Dazzle. Or maybe a Treant Protector, something that can mitigate the squishiness that an Ember Spirit has early on and even later on throughout the game. Something that we've seen in the Western scene recently. Just pick up an Ember Spirit, pick up a Treant Protector to help him out from all across the map. And make him, give him the ability to dive even deeper than he normally would be. But yeah, Execration, we're picking up a good lineup of their own. Nature's Prophet to counter the push with some more Red Dodo. Sand King also picked up, and Shadow Shaman as well, so very greedy supports here. Unless they want to run Sand King in some sort of a mid-roll, would work in this case,
I suppose. 10 seconds to go.
I mean, usually you say Ember Spirit, which I assume will be mid. It can be a Lycanthrope, but then again, it wouldn't make too much of a difference. Yeah, Sand King.
Reserve time.
Really good against melee mid heroes, simply because he will skill the what's it called, Caustic Finale at level 1. And then whenever you want to get close to do some CS, the things will explode on you and you take so much harassment damage. So I've seen that against Dragon Knights. Dragon Knights just get shit upon by Sand King, but yeah.
Radiant's pick.
Otherwise, if Sand King and Shadow Shaman are supports, it's very greedy, because both of them need levels and don't do too much at level 1. I mean, I suppose Shadow Shaman can hex someone and give Sand King enough time to get a burst strike in at level 1. It's not really effective, and then again, you still don't have too much damage. Morphling, though, can help with in that department at the very least. He gives you a lot of early damage in the laning stage. And later on, he's a decent carry, very tanky and hard to bring down if he plays it right with the replicates as well as the strength morph. So,
reserve time.
Morphling can definitely stand up to someone like a Lycanthrope. Or an Ember Spirit, really, but yeah, then again, you probably have to have a replicate up. I don't know that Strength Morph is enough to go through the massive amounts of single target DPS that Lycanthrope has, once he has a Necro Creep and maybe a Medallion of Courage. That's gonna be a Dazzle, so yeah. We mentioned earlier in conjunction with the Ember Spirit, able to keep him alive early on if they maybe do a dual lane or something silly like that. But of course it also works very well for the same reason with the Lycanthrope.
10 seconds to go.
Able to keep him alive in the laning stage, give him enough space. It is level 6, at which point, and this Vladimir's offering, at which point he can just use the jungle, go anywhere on the map, and not fear too much. Because he can always rely on his ultimate to try and run away. So unless there's perfect chain stunning coming out from the Sand King or also Shadow Shaman, not a whole lot Lycanthrope has to fear once he's at level 6. So, but yeah. There's basically two ways to try and counter a Lycanthrope, two or three. First would be to try and put off enough pressure on him early, before he hits his level 6, so that he's basically shut down and is so far away from his core items that you're able to snowball from there. But with Sand King and Shadow Shaman not really doing a whole lot early on, at least until they got a couple of levels at the very least, probably not gonna be the case.
Radiant's ban.
The other thing is that you have a lineup that can defend the base easily. And up until now they have some okay wave clear with the Shadow Shaman Aether Shock doing some good damage. But apart from that, Morphling Waveform, he doesn't want to be relegated to base defense duty necessarily. Go. So yeah, if you can hold the base and hold out long enough for your hard farming carry to really come online, then you are able to stand up against Lycanthrope, but then again, in this game you have to consider the Ember Spirit. If you give him enough time and all the map to farm up, then he will be scary as well and just one or two shot Shadow Shaman in the backlines with the Sleight of Fist. But yeah, we'll see how this turns out. I hope Execration has a game plan, because Lycanthrope and Ember Spirit, there's a reason that at least one of them will get banned out in the first two bans usually.
10 seconds to go. 5 seconds.
Alright, dipping into the
reserve
last bit of the
time.
Bonus time for the last pick. And it's gonna be a Magnus. Okay, so
Radiance
really
pit.
Greedy support, Magnus mid. Up against the Tinker though, huh? It's alright, I suppose. Oh, but how are they gonna lane this? Might be an offlane Tinker, now that I think about it. Because how else would they lane this? But yeah, we'll see how this turns out. Magnus should do alright simply
because he has
the Shockwave to be able to rely upon to get a CS, and he isn't relying on right clicks only. Because if you're a hero that relies on right clicks only up against a Tinker, then you're in trouble, because he can laser you and you miss everything, but Ember Spirit mid. Make more sense, and Tinker probably heading to the offlane or something like that. But yeah, doesn't seem like there's any action early on. Let's take a look at our lineups. We've got Ninja Boogie on the Morphling, Fox on the Sand King, mid player playing the mid on Magnus, which leaves BG01 on the support Shadow Shaman, and Loimic on the offlane Nature's Prophet. On the other side of the river, we've got Visage playing the Enchantress. Funnily enough,
30 seconds to go.
Checking the Ancient Camp. KS on the mid Ember Spirit. Lobby playing the support Dazzle. Chains on the Tinker, which leaves Dafa, or something like that, on the Lycanthrope. So yeah, dual lane coming out here, it seems. Well, in this situation, it's alright, I suppose. I mean, Lycanthrope is up against Nature's Prophet. It will be a little bit annoying with the Treants, but he can easily counter that harassment with wolves of his own. So that shouldn't be too much of a problem. In this case, he will be able to hold his own normally against aggressive tri-lanes or some other sort of lanes or strong one-on-one heroes. It's a little bit different because Lycanthrope doesn't have too much of an early game presence, but yeah. And hell, if he needs to, Visage can roam around with the creep early on and help him out too. Right, this little middle lane mashup. Ember Spirit should take the advantage late on until he gets when he gets a couple of levels. He hasn't put a point up into anything yet. But yeah. Normally Ember Spirit is considered a good mid hero against melees because he has the Flame Guard. That does damage over time, and the enemy hero of course has to get close to get CS usually. So you're able to dish out a lot of free harassment. But that doesn't come online until you have a couple of levels at the very least, and KS needs at least 2 points into the Flame Guard. Because 1 point will just be swept by a single shockwave, so. We'll keep an eye on that. We'll see in the bottom lane. Lumix shouldn't die unless we got some good rotation from the Enchantress creep. But yeah, one thing this does, and yeah, we see the first creep already up in the top lane to help zone out Ninja Boogie, and yeah. With the early game nuking potential from a Tinker as well as the mischance that comes from the laser, Morphling already took a lot of damage. Ninja Boogie not having the best time. Yeah, his support can't really do much. Aether Shock level 1 is a really good spell, but it's only hitting on one target, and it's fairly steep mana cost for what it does. And yeah, Fox, Burrow Strike, level 1, look at the range, right? Not exactly. Oh crap, the overlay. Ah, I'm sorry. Oh, not that. There we go. Ah, sorry guys, I still have to get used to it. First time I actually have that overlay available. Last time around, when I first cast it for the JoinDOTA community. And yeah. Visage doing good job sending the creeps every which way and putting it after harassment. But yeah, first time cast for JoinDOTA community, yeah, I had really short notice and didn't have time to set up the overlay at all. No. But there's gonna be Shackles though onto KS and a lot of right clicks. Doesn't have his ultimate available yet. Lumic coming in to join the action. Will take a lot of damage, but yeah. Visage roaming around, actually getting the first blood. Sort of. But yeah, now they have to stop. And yeah, they will find the Sand King as well, so very nice rotation from Visage. Roaming through the enemy jungle with his creeps. Sort of getting the first blood. I mean, the creeps ended up getting last hit on Magnus, but as it stands, 2-0 in favor of Departure right now. And I want to turn this into a push, but I don't think they can. Yep. Nice try, but Ember Spirit early on. He put 2 levels into Flame Guard, which I like. I often see Ember Spirits going the maxing out the Searing Chains as well as the Slide of Fist first, which is very aggressive. But up against the Shockwave of a Magnus, I really like the Flame Guard build better. Because it just protects you, it keeps you from dying too much. And that's something that you usually have problems with. Meanwhile, in top lane, Ninja Boogie not having the best time, to say the least. I mean, Tinker sitting at 18 last hits as opposed to 13, and in the meantime, Alpha in the bottom lane, he's just basically getting free from. I mean, Lumix can dish out some harassment, but Lycanthrope all got the Morbid Mask up, so you'll be able to have that lifesteal to help him out in terms of regen. He's well on his way to a Vladimir's Offering at this rate, sitting at 24 last hits right now. Ember Spirit almost level 6, at which point he probably won't die if he uses the Remnants defensively. And he finds himself a double damage rune. That will be helpful. He might use it to put up some pressure down here. Lumic didn't see that, okay. I don't think so. Nope. Still there. Searing Chains, he'll have to come out. Flame Guard's already up. Hey, oh no, he's actually blocked himself in. Yeah, holding on to the Searing Chains until the teleport comes out. Very smart from KS there. Gets an easy kill on Nature's Prophet. But playing in the meantime, Visage putting out some wards, keeping tabs on the supports. Send your ward, actually. Oh, there's gonna be Shags on Chains under the tower, but the Mushroom Machines goes. Burst Strike to follow it up. Dazzle will he be able to keep him alive just a little bit longer, but Lumic rotating in. Shallow Grave will not make this easy, but Ninja Boogie. Yeah, Tinker will fall. Ninja Boogie, though, might be the return kill. Visage wants it, he wants it, and he is quite hard to kill with the attendants going, but Ninja Boogie should be able to get away. Lumic trying his best to dish out enough harassment. That's gonna be just Sprout. Is there any burst strike to follow up? No. Fox doesn't get in range of it. Visage will be able to get the hell out of there. Alright. Shadow Shaman die there as well. I believe so. But yeah. Visage, he's got a following. Fox doesn't want to let that go. But KS now. Coming to protect him. It'd be too much of a problem. So yeah, Tinker takes a fall. And
the Dire might want to mine their top tower.
There's something going on. Fox actually taking a lot of damage from the shockwave as well as the right click from that Setar Tormentor, but he should be alright.
The Dire best do something about that bottom tower.
Wait, you see how much damage that March of Machines did? It's 3 points up on it already.
Dire's bottom tower is getting the business.
Yeah, he got that off before I got shackled up, so. I mean, he was gonna die eventually, of course. He was right in the tower, he gets spotted up, he gets stunned up. But yeah, while all that was happening, Dafa was down here in the bottom lane. He's going to town, this tower is almost dead. He's actually gonna commit to finish it off. In the high range now, and he might be forced off, but he really wants to go for it. Oh, he's actually gonna go on Lumic. Nice, aggressive spirit, and a couple of right clicks. Is there gonna be enough time? Yes, there is. With one last light of fist. Far up, right below the tower, though. Are there any TP reactions? No. None of the sort, so KS, another good rotation from him with the haste from. Didn't even see him there until he got the better of the Nature's Prophet, and yeah, he doesn't have a good time. He is level 6, that's all he has is his face boots, far away from any sort of Midas. Unless something's on the courier. But nope. Just a teleport scroll. And yeah, Visage, excellent Enchantress player. He always gets the Wild Wings and he always has the Tornadoes running to try and shut down Morphling, and he's done a good job. I mean, he's sitting at 24 CS, got a bottle, got a magic wand, got a Winged Basilisk and boots, but that's about it. 7 minutes in, it's not exactly a sign of a free farming Morphling. Bottom lane, Fox trying to defend, but he might be in trouble. Dafa is putting out some pressure with the ultimate form and might just go all the way. The tier 2 tower doing a lot more damage than the tier 1 tower. Not feeling comfortable. Got a Vladimir's Offering, going for the treads next, and after that, possibly a Medallion, and after that, the Necrobook. Unless you just want to rush it. Keeping his options open right now with the Belt of Strength. But yeah, things if you build a Medallion, then you have a really good Roche lineup, but you're not on the Dire side, so. A little bit dangerous. And you have a Macross on the other team. He doesn't have his Blink Dagger though. In fact, he's very far from it. He's had to deal with some harassment and KS. On the Ember Spirit, really going to town. Going straight for the drums, actually not going for Space Boots or Treads or Arcane Boots even first. Interesting build. Very well rounded in terms of skill build though. Doesn't prioritize anything too much. Has the Flame got to be able to fall back on. Side of Fizz with a slightly lower cooldown level 2. To be able to dish out harassment at a little bit better rate. But for now, both teams just biding the time. Keep doing what they're doing, putting on pressure on all the lanes. Bombing up. Yeah, Ninja Boogie can go into the marching machines, it just can't. Or else he will die horribly. Yeah, that's really what worries me about execration right now. That Morphling is gonna get online really, really late. If he doesn't get early farm, he's pretty much useless. Gonna have to rely on the Magnus to make some plays once he gets his Blink Dagger, but mentioned it's still a couple of minutes off. Depart. One slide of fist and Searing Chains. It was already in kill range. KS wanted to go for it. Could have probably popped one or two remnants, blown him up. So, Magnus has to be careful. Yeah, with all that space, with all the pressure on the middle lane as well as on the top lane, Dafa is just free. Lumic will actually die here before I can teleport out. The massive amounts of damage and the crits coming out from the ultimate form were enough. James is here. He's got his Boots of Troubles already, so he will be here to help that push. Magnus, he has an RP available. That might be enough to scare them off. But they already did so much damage, they picked up another kill. So, next time Dafa is left alone here, this tower will go down. effective right now. He doesn't have his ultimate available to fall back on, though, so... Has to leave it in Dire range, mid player would just...
Dire's mid tower could use a little help. Looks like Dire's bottom tower...
Research looks like he might be going for a medallion with the chainmail. Or a mechanism. Either one would be fine. Fox? The sandstorm, but... Sandstorm does not protect you against the modern machines. They do see the sandstorm, so yeah. James will just do what a tinker does. He will just die from that, in fact.
That's four in a row.
Oh my, yeah, he was blocked out by the tree. He couldn't get out of there. He could have burst right out, I guess, but yeah. Shadow Shaman, not so lucky. Visage taking a lot of damage from Nature's Prophet ultimate, but not enough. This top tower will go down.
Dire's top tower's getting beat down.
Two heroes on the sidelines for Execration.
Dire's
got a double damage from the Ember Spear. Definitely helped out there. First Departure doing a good job right now. Once again, just to remind you guys, whoever wins this match will stay in Division 1, and whoever loses this match will have to fight themselves through the playoffs to accomplish that. Two Sleight of Fists, Lumic should die if he goes into that, but no, yeah, that's not feeling comfortable playing very safe. He was just probably... No, he didn't have any runners left. Well, that's what was said. Oh. Engagement in jungle. Fox, he just doesn't know what to do. All we use his spells and he'll just run around and die. Dylan will protect himself so he won't even fall because of it, or maybe he will. One last Aether Shark. KS though, not quite done yet.
Tower's having technical difficulties.
Visage actually picked up both of these kills, but yeah, no, not pursuing any further, just taking the objectives off the map. Black Control rotating into middle lane, that's another tower down. First Departure. None of their towers even have seen any action yet. Apart from the mid-tier one. But yeah, that's exactly where he wants to be as a Lycanthrope. He's gone straight for the Necrobox that will be level 2. And with the rest of his team... Yeah, this is going for the mechanism instead of the medallion. But even without the medallion, right now they have enough damage to bring down his Roshan pretty damn quickly. Fox just trying to be annoying here. Chains might have to rotate in and just dish out some... martial machines, but... That's gonna be Morphling. Ninja will be going for it though. He's trying to do what he can, but Roshan will fall. Ninja Boogie will actually snatch it. There's gonna be the RP. And this and the epicenter going off. Yeah, Shadow Wraith keeping Duff alive for just a little bit longer. Taking out a lot of damage, but he should fall at the very end. To one last Shockwave. Ninja Boogie still alive. I can't even believe it. Oh, well, he popped his Aegis, so now it's gonna be body blocked up by Dazzle and KS, looking for some revenge. He will get it. 4-for-2 trade, but Execration gets the Roshan, gets the Aegis, so denying that is a really big feat. Not sure if it was worth it though. Let's actually take a look at the gold graphs, and yeah, First Departure already far, far ahead before that. Yeah, graphs going down just a little bit, so Execration doing what they could, and yeah, there was some excellent play there. Extremely risky, but extremely lucky. At least they stemmed the bleeding with that, sort of, but losing four heroes there. Even though he had an excellent initiation with the RP. Showing off the Blink Dagger from Magnus.
Beat down.
Not quite enough to ensure a really, really good win. But yeah, up against the Lycanthrope as well as an Ember Spit, well, that farmed. Not as well as a Tinker. Can just split push your lanes in the meantime and just join the fight and dish out lots of damage with the Marshall Machines maxed out this early on. It's basically everything he wants right now. In terms of split pushing, just teleport, blink, throw two matches, go away. Yeah. Next item may be a Dagon if he wants to go YOLO, or maybe something like a Cypher Vice, which would help a lot. In terms of team fights, just having the Chain Hex available. Yeah, he's going for the Cypher Vice. Three standards and strong pickup, so once he gets that, we might see him just join teamfights a little bit more often than just go for ganks on his own. If he finds someone isolated. Like the Morphling up here. Ninja Boogie doesn't have a rapid give up just for now, but... If he isn't careful about that later on, once Tinker gets his hex, then he might be in trouble if he's all alone. And the rest of his team not alone though, they're all together smoked up looking for something, but it's only Visage here in the front lines.
Dire's mid towers having
First Departure with a good spread, not allowing for any sort of RP, but that's gonna be a hex on Visage, but now misses the Yeah, misses the Ward Trap, lots of damage coming up. Wizard will die in the end, so will the Shadow Shaman. Yeah, Chains will just teleport out as Sand King dies in the backlines. Through the Flame Guard as well as Master Machine, so Ward's pretty much wasted. The one that can probably farm them up. But KS, this, he's feeling quite tanky. He's going for Battle Fury or a Lincoln Sphere. Probably Lincoln's, since you picked up the Perseverance first, but I really don't know. Don't know for sure. Considering the amount of fighting he does, Lincoln's Fury wouldn't be too bad. He will find mid play. The Chains are gonna miss though, but doesn't even need it. Flame Guard does some good damage. There's gonna be the RP though! It's gonna miss! Shackle's bummed though, KS. Taking a lot of damage just out of Tower Range. Shadow Grave! Will keep him alive for now. Ninja will be not able to seal the deal, and now will just be able to teleport the hell back to base. Very nice play there from Lobby. Keeping the Ember Spirit alive at the very end there. Chains now, mind control, he's crowded up, hexed up. Treants will come out, but the hex only level 1, nothing to hold up. Shackles will be interrupted immediately, so. Yeah, Shashama's actually the one who will fall. Ninja Boogie, all of a sudden left alive, Impetus doing good damage, and that's a team wipe. GG is called. Sorry for my voice.
That's a win for the
right overlay? Yes. Alright. GG is called. First Departure rolls over Execration, and they will stay in Division 1 for the next season, which will start at the end of April, sort of, I believe. Not exactly set in stone yet, but the playoffs are all scheduled right now, so head over to joindota.com, check that out. And yeah, there's a lot of info, lots of games left to be played, so get ready for more Dota in the weeks to come. But yeah, sorry about the overlay earlier. Once again, it was the first time I actually got this all set up. And still have to get used to it, so. Hope you enjoyed it. And for now, it's DragonDrop signing off.